Hello, and welcome to KDAB News, the monthly update for professionals working with Qt, C++, and 3D technologies. I'm Robert Brock, and before we start, I'd like to make you aware that the call for speakers for Qt Desktop Days will end soon. So, if you have any topics around desktop development with Qt that you would like to present, we are happy to hear from you. You can find the link below. Coming back to the news, in this edition we have What Does Axivion Do? An interview with Daniel Simon and Jere Hurskainen from the Qt Group. Qt 6.5 LTS. More Qt releases, Qt Creator 10, Qt for Python 6.5, Qt for MCU 2.4. Tip of the month and announcements. In August 2022, the Qt Group acquired Axivion, a provider for static code analysis. Today, I speak with Axivion's Head of Professional Services, Dr. Daniel Simon, and with the Senior Product Manager for Static Code and Software Architecture Analysis, Jere Hurskainen, to find out more about what Axivion does and what further plans the Qt Group has with the integration with Qt and other tools. Hello, Jere and Daniel. Thank you for coming.
Thank you for the invitation.
Yeah, thank you.
So, first of all, what does Axivion do?
The basic claim is we are stopping software erosion. So if you have not heard that term before, software erosion is something similar to technical debt or even stopping unmaintainable software. So we try to make sure that your software is not only looking good by using maybe a Qt interface, by having the right functionality, by having the right usability. We more or less change the perspective to a developer's view. So we believe that if your software is maintainable, if your software can be adopted to customers' requirements, that is essential for the overall development and evolution of the product. And we now on the perspective of the software engineer. So we try to make the software to come in a better shape for understandability from the engineering perspective, try to avoid programming errors by finding them as early as possible by means of static analysis. And we try to keep you in the position to maintain the overall complexity of the software. I think the biggest example here is there's a lot of static code analysis in the world. What we have as maybe one of the unique selling points is this architecture verification. So typically when you start with boxes and arrows on a flip chart, that would be something like an architecture. And then we can make sure that your flip chart architecture is compliant with what you implement in the code. That's on the very high level. Of course, you can also take other modeling approaches like something UMLish that we take as an input, and then we can contrast it to your real implementation in the software. And overall, in the lifecycle of the product, that makes the improves the maintainability from the engineering perspective. It also lets your software project live a longer life. So you're not reaching end of maintainability before the end of life of the product. That's, I think, one of the most important parts.
Agreed. Lifecycle and maintainability are really good investments when it comes to software. So what goals does the Qt company have with adding Axivion to the portfolio?
As you told, Qt company acquired Axivion GmbH in the August of 2022. The starting point for the acquisitions actually happened already in April 21, when the Qt company acquired FlockLogic GmbH, which is also a Germany-based quality assurance company. What we try to do, as Qt is well known for the development tools, but we look what do the customers and the users of the Qt products do. And of course, adding the testing and the quality assurance offering to the portfolio was a natural step from that point of view. And now with the Axivion, we have added the world leading tools in the static code analysis and the software architecture analysis.
And from the technical perspective, there are a lot of ideas now in the room. I think we have now static code analysis in the portfolio. We have also the dynamic analysis with Twish, Coco, Test Center, all those nice things. And if you look at what is on the market, there is actually always only the dynamic testing or static testing. And now we have a lot of ideas also to combine the information from both sides for the benefit of the customer. Simple example is why should I start testing before I have a go from the static analysis that the code does not have to be changed anymore? That's a very simple one. And the other way around, of course, there are some static analyses that are by nature undecidable. So maybe checks like every out of bounds checks, null pointer checks, though the static analysis cannot always say for sure it's okay or it's not okay. But there we can produce hints towards the testers that they should provide the right test cases. And the other way around, if you have the test cases, you can be pretty sure that your static analysis can be approved here. So that's a lot of ideas. I'm really looking forward to the future here, because that would be very unique.
And of course, to add, finally, this is one of the values why we decided to add Axivion, is to increase the whole value through the whole customer lifecycle, to be with them and to support and to be the best business partners for them.
Yes, perfect. And finally, how can people get started with your tools?
Get in touch with your either Qt, KDAP contact, or click at the link below.
Yep, we'll add everything in the description down below. Awesome. Well, thank you very much for your time.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Qt 6.5 is the next Qt version with long-term support after version 6.2. It brings many fixes and general improvements, as well as new functionality for graphics and UI developers and the application backend. Among the highlights, there's improved theming and styling. For example, applications can easily support dark mode on Windows. And Qt Quick Controls now includes the iOS style, implementing also many controls that don't have an equivalent on native iOS. There are also improvements done to the platform support. With Qt 6.5 comes support for Android 12, while making sure that Qt keeps working, as expected, on the older versions. The update further adds new features on top of Qt 6.4 and previous Qt 6 releases. Just to pick a few examples, Table View got support for interactive features such as in-place editing of cells, resizing rows and columns, and multi-selection. TreeView's Delegate also supports in-place editing, and the Qt Quick Input Handlers got a few new properties. One tool of the Qt Quick Compiler, the QML Type Compiler, supports more QML constructs now, most notably translation bindings, inline components, singletons, and signal handlers. The QML Script Compiler, implemented in the tools QML Cache Gen and QML SC, can now handle more JavaScript constructs, such as output via console, LET and const, or string building via arg. Many platforms require explicit permission from the user before an application can access certain services. With Qt's new permission APIs, applications can now check and request permission for features that require such consent. There are many more updates, and you can read all about them on the blog linked below. Right after our last news edition, the latest version of Qt Creator came out. Most important updates in Qt Creator 10. It now ships with LLVM 16, which improves C++ 20 support in Clang, and the interaction between Qt Creator and Clang D. Also, the code model is updated to 6.5, so that the editor now shows a color preview or corresponding properties as a tooltip, and you can specify an external command like QML format to format files instead of the built-in formatter. Usually, with every new Qt version, there comes also a new version of Qt for Python. In version 6.5, the modules and classes have been included, such as Qt Text-to-Speech, Qt Serial Bus, and Qt Location. Also, many classes from the existing modules have been adapted and improved. Additionally, many shared pointer types of Q3D are included as well. Property Reader Interface, Q Texture Image Data, and, of course, Q Texture Image Data Generator. There are many more improvements, so you can read up on them in the blog linked below. And of course, last but not least, the Qt for MCU's 2.4 release includes several new features and improvements as well. including support for sprite animations, a more flexible code generation and build process, among others. Animated Sprite and Animated Sprite Directory are new to Qt Quick Ultralight, types that enable playback of pre-rendered video frames with animation speed control and compile time optimizations for reducing ROM usage. Read more about all the updates below the video. The familiar solution for thick value classes that want to preserve binary compatibility is to use the pimple pattern, private implementation, also known as dpointer, pointer to data. In the latest blog post by my colleague Giuseppe D'Angelo, he explains how in future versions of a class, you can freely change the contents of the pimple, like adding, removing, or even modifying data members, but the binary compatibility of the public class gets preserved. You can read all about it by following the link below. On the 20th and 21st of June, KDAV is organizing an online event called Qt Desktop Days. As mentioned in the intro, the call for speakers is still open. So if you have a topic specific to desktop development with Qt, we are happy to hear from you. And if you would like to attend the event, then simply mark your calendar. The event is free to attend, and videos will be released at a later date. Here are some more upcoming events in May and June that might interest you. The Open Source Summit North America, happening from 10th to the 12th of May in Vancouver, Canada. The Italian C++ Conference on the 10th of June in Rome. Nice. And the Embedded Open Source Summit from the 27th to the 30th of June in Prague. Thank you for watching. Stay safe and feel free to share any feedback or questions below the video. I'll see you next time.